Blog Talk Radio.
Book of Revelation, chapter 7, verses 16 and 17.
Yes, sir.
They shall hunger no more, neither shall they thirst anymore.
Preach, preacher.
For God shall wipe away,
yes, sir,
every tear from their eye.
Yes, sir.
Get ready for the revolution.
Kicking the people down, pushing them around and knocking them down, and now they're messing with the indigenous people. They done mess with the wrong people. I know my people. I'm an Anishinaabe people. Do you understand that? First people that lived on this land. I know my people. You cannot push them around. They woke up a sleeping giant, a sleeping tiger that's out and about. An ominous has picked up on it. They joined forces with the Idle No More movement. On December 21st, on the solstice, on the end of the Mayan calendar, all First Nation people around the world got together, sang the same songs, beat the same drums. As the solstice passed it over them, that was high noon, people. High noon. Get it? That's not a coincidence. Might be superstitious, you might say. But now you're going to find out what's really, really, really solidarity is. My people stick together. My great, great, seven generations grandfather was chief of the non-removable nation of Big Sandy. Sandy Lake in Minnesota. Breech Tooth, that's what they called them in English. Is that a coincidence that I have breech teeth? That I got a gap? I don't think so. Oh, what a show, what a show. Today I'm going to talk about the Jester, my buddy. I got a call here, but it keeps on going off every time I go to click in, buddy. I don't know what you're doing there. But you can have a chat with the Jester now when you go to his page. I don't know if anybody knew that. If he's available, he'll pop up a little chat window and you can chat with him. Well, I went back when someone told me that there are some postings again from the Jester on me in his, on his page or web page, whatever you call it, WordPress or whatever. So I went over there and a little chat window popped up. Woo! I was surprised. So me and Chester had a long, long chat. Okay, caller, I don't know who you are, but every time I go to answer you, you keep on hanging up on me. I won't read your number out loud. I don't do that kind of stuff. Probably the most honest person on the internet. Most trustworthy is me. And I mean that, too. Okay, on with the show. The Jester. So I had a long chat with him. Wasn't a friendly chat or anything like that. On my part, I was trying to be friendly. I don't know if anybody out there ever talked with me before. Well, anyways, we had a talk. And he believed that a video that I put out long, long time ago was new, apparently. And what it was, See, the first video I put out was saying that Jester, the Jester, was a child molester. And that he was kicked out of the military because they found pornographic, child pornographic material on his computer. That was the first video I made. Actually, it was just a tweet, and then it turned into a video and whatever. I didn't think it would be this big of a thing 2 years later, still coming up. I haven't tweeted on a Jester in over a year. But then his name came up on a child porn site, Black Op, where the anonymous movement was going after child pornography sites, doxing them, and also DDoSing them and doxing them, going inside and hacking them, getting all the information. They got a lot of names off of it, and a Jester's name came up on one of them. So I made a video on that right after it happened, right after that went down. Now, Jester should have known that because he commented on it and said that it was a setup. Someone set him up by putting his name on that site. Now, I don't know anything about that, okay? I wasn't involved in that hack or dox or whatever. I knew about it when it was going down, but there was other things going on that I was involved in. So you got to stick with one op. I always say that. Pick something you're passionate about, which child pornography is a horrible thing, and I'd like to see it all wiped out throughout the world. But I was working on another op at the time, and I don't believe in working three ops at the same time. So anyways, I don't know anything about his name on there or why it was on there. I know all the speculations, and I know all the people coming out sticking up for him, and some people saying that it was his name and he was part of it. That's up to them. I have no part of that. But I did make a video, and apparently Jester thought it was a new video and was quite upset about it and started posting things about me on his webpage. Again, call in, people. Look at all these fucking people in the room, and you're all just sitting there. And all guests. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. I do not censor people. But anyways, so while talking with the Jester, or chatting with him in his chat room, in his on his webpage, I told him, that's an old video. I did that a long time ago. So he asked me who he was, and I told him. I said, you're Dave Green. First I said Dave, and he said, Dave what? And I said, Green. And he says, you're wrong. Well, that's fine. That's okay. That's what I thought he was. But when I started out making that video, the first video, and then bringing that tweet out, it was a straight-out lie, I'll admit it, but it was a white lie. Because what he was doing, I thought was horrible, horrible, by hacking WikiLeaks, by going in and DDoSing him. He doesn't hack him. He's got a bot. So I just thought, hey, who is this guy and what is he doing and how come he's doing this stuff? Who is he? So I looked into him and I found out a lot of things about him. And I said, well, I just had got done seeing the movie Hackers 2, I think they call it, but it's another name to it. But in my apology video to Jester, I put the link in there to the movie. It's a pretty good movie. It's about Knack Knacker. It's actually based off the story of Knack Knack and what he'd done and things like that. But one of the things in there was they wanted to discredit somebody, so they called him a child molester, and that's what I did. 2 years later, they're still talking about it. So I squashed it. I put out the video. It's true. It's me. I didn't purposely have a backlight or anything. Just where I do my videos. It just so happened to be sunny out that day. And I didn't have the inside lights on, so it looks like a shadowy figure there. But if Jester wants me to make another one, I'll make another one with my face and everything, because I'm going to make some videos today. I just did another blog talk, Midnight Rambler blog talk. And now I'm doing this one, and I'm going to make a video, and then I'm done for today. But that's the truth, people. If everybody wanted me, if you come in here to listen to John Tiessen rip the Jester, you're not going to hear it. I think everybody's got a place and a voice on the internet, and everybody's free to say whatever they want and do whatever they want. Anytime I am in control, if you go look at my YouTube videos, you can post what you want, say what you want, do what you want, post videos if you want onto my videos, steal my videos, take them, use them as your own. I don't believe in censorship. I don't believe in copyright. Unless you're out selling them, making money on it, then I think that's wrong. You know, if I make something and you start making money on it, but if you make a copy of it and keep it for yourself, I don't see nothing wrong with that. So I am a true believer in no censorship at all. Unlike a lot of people that say they have the idea and they censor people in their chat rooms, on their streams. Okay, I don't do that. I don't censor anybody. You could say whatever you want on my YouTube videos, on this page, on anything I'm in control of. No censorship. So feel free to say what you want or use anything I have. That's from me, John Tiessen, to you. There's nothing that pisses me off more is when I watch a stream at some Occupy movement and they're booting people out of the room, out of the chat room. Well, first of all, what the hell are you doing in keeping your eyes on a chat that fucking long if you're at an Occupy movement? Get your ass off the chair, put the computer down and put the camera down, stop looking at the chat, and participate in the Occupy movement. You're all gun-ho just blocking people, what they're saying and what they're doing. Oh, I don't agree with that. You're blocked. So you're protesting against one thing, and you're doing what you're protesting against. You got to pick a side. Well, first, know yourself. And then pick a side and stick to it. But, you know, you can still change your mind. Don't get me wrong. But this hypocritical bullshit. Oh, Twitter kicked me off their site. Oh, look at that asshole. He just posted in my stream. I'm going to block him and kick him off my site. Well, it doesn't make sense, does it? Get real. You don't like anything I say on Twitter. I could care less. I'm not going to block you. Why would you want to block somebody on Twitter? It's unbelievable that people say they have the idea and they block people. The idea of an ominous, that's equality through everybody, for everybody. Okay, I got a caller here, and I hope he doesn't hang up, but I hope he's got some decent questions. Hello, caller, you're on the air, buddy.
Hello there.
Hello, how are you doing today?
Pretty good. I figured I'd call in to ask, why is Jester so obsessed with you? Any idea?
I don't know. I think it's back a long time ago. I don't know how long you've been listening to the show, but I did a tweet. A long time ago, I did a tweet. I think that upset him. It hit a nerve. You know, I've been called worse myself. But why does this upset him so bad? I'm not a psychologist. You know, I took courses and things like that. But, I really don't know the guy well just by his tweets and things like that. Your guess is as good as mine.
Well, I watched during, like, the Cube Spherical stuff, too. Or he blamed you of running that account.
I missed that one. See, a lot of stuff I miss. I know you thought I was medley, smiley, or something like that back when. Now, that was the last time I was dragged into any conversation with the Jester. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah, that was quite a thing. So what I did is I ran a show and just opened up the lines, and everybody that called in, I just opened their lines. And I didn't talk or anything. Then my second show I had to do on it because people were mad at me. I had to do another show on it. So I just said, I don't know who that guy is or what his thing is, and the Rubik's Cube and all that things like that. That's fine. If they want to blame me for that, that's fine. But if they want to know the truth, all they got to do is ask me. I don't lie. I don't lie about my life. I don't lie about anything I've done. I don't lie about what Jester's done or what I've done to the Jester. Now I'm coming clean. You know, have you ever seen the movie, that Hackers 2 movie about Knock Knock?
Yeah, I have.
And where they try to discredit that fella when they said that he was a child molester. That's where I got the idea from. So that's why I posted. Have any more questions, sir?
Not that I can think of.
Do you have any questions about me? Because I would like to answer some questions about myself. People hear things out there about me, but no one asks me. I mean, when I'm sitting there in the tiny chats with Barrett Brown back when, all these people are ripping me. But here I am sitting there. All they got to do is ask me. You know, anything in the world, anybody wants to ask me, I'm open and you'll get an honest answer. And if you don't want to hear the truth, don't ask me, because that's all you're going to get from me is the truth, the straight truth. I think I know who you are.
Who am I?
I got to look. Give me a second. Oh, shit. These damn internets. No, I'm joking. Opposer, obozer, or whatever. Right?
No, this is Sanguinarious.
Oh, okay. I see you there.
I said I'd call in.
Cool, you did. You're a good man to your word. And then I think we did some tiny chats, right? In Barrett Brown's rooms?
Yeah, we talked a few times. And
yeah, I recognize your voice. I know I'm a little creepy sometimes, and I kind of say things that people take offense to because I'm just too honest, I think. I wear my emotions on my sleeve, and I just say what I want to say without not intentionally trying to hurt people. You know, I think I remembered a question I asked you, and you got kind of upset over it. And I apologize for it. And I don't think we talk since. But I sure miss Barrett Brown.
I do too. I miss Barrett a lot. It sucks that he's gone, because, like, I miss, like, going into tiny chats and see him, like, being a doofus.
Well, there's one thing I liked about his tiny chats was that we got a lot of things done, and also we got a lot of laughs out of it. And I'm not the fastest reader in the world, and I try to do as best as I could for Project PM. And but, you know, I could try to dig through all those documents, and people, by the time I had it, someone already posted it or talked about it or went through it and whatever. But I would say, no, everybody, all we got to do is wait for the trial to come up, because these are very thin charges they have on them. They're reaching. They overcharged them, and jurors will listen to you. He was indicted by a grand jury, which is quite different than a jury of your peers. So you don't need as much evidence to be indicted. They can indict a toothbrush if they, you know, wanted to.
That had to have been a pretty naughty toothbrush.
Well, you know what they say about toothbrushes. They get around in little crevices. And, no, I don't know what to say.
I see. This is interesting. He deleted all the tweets about your show.
Who did?
Jester, after he tweeted it out.
Oh, that's okay. Yeah, and he's taking that video that I made and stuff, and he can do whatever he wants with it, and that's fine. I don't, you know, like I said, I made the video. I put it out there. He's running with it. A bit trolling, like, kind of trying to agitate me to get me going. But, you know, like I said, I don't censor shit anybody. I don't censor nobody. People have their own opinion. They can say what they want. They can do what they want. You know, I'm a pretty good troller myself. But I think that if I went at him and got all pissed off at him, I would be going against my own principles. So he can do what he wants with it. He can take his tweets and tweet and then delete them, you know, just like I can. The only thing I don't agree, he blocks people. And I don't, you know, if you're going to talk censorship and rights and human rights and America that's on freedom of speech, censors, you know, blocking people and things like that. Not that you can't look at his website, you know, but I just don't believe in it.
Yeah, I just find it silly. He does it, like, to the extreme. Like, anyone that says anything or doesn't kiss his ass, he blocks instantly.
Yeah, and it's just his prerogative, but then people know where he's coming from. They know, you know what I mean, what he's about and what he's doing. And he certainly ain't hiding it. You know, he says it's his Twitter. He can block whoever he wants, which is true.
Yep, that is true. It is his Twitter, but he just acts like an ass all the time.
Well, I think he's done good in some things, like when he went after the West Baptist Church. He kind of joined in on a few things. He's got that botnet that's pretty cool. DDoS people on his own. There's a few good things about it, about him, that you can't not look at. And what I do is when I find somebody I do not like, you can focus in on the points you don't like, or, and then be miserable and be angry all the time, or focus in on the things you like about the person and not be angry. You know, that's why I am amazed that people get pissed off on a tweet. You know, like I said, I've been called everything in the book. You name a name, I've been called it. You know, and to be pissed off over it is beyond my comprehension. I don't understand how people actually get mad.
Yeah, it's text on the internet, and they get so mad over it. I just find it amusing, personally.
Yeah, it's a bit amusing. I trolled some people to the point where they cried and then did tiny chats with them and then retracted or deleted the things that they were mad about. That's where I come from. You know what I mean? I'm not out to hurt anybody, but I'm not going to troll people. You know what I mean? So if I can troll people, but I only troll people that can take it, I guess. Maybe. Maybe that's where I come from. But I had a few people get in touch with me, and why are you doing this? And why? Well, geez, you did this and you did that. You're saying this about me. Why can't I say that about you? You know what I mean? So it's just like, okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. Forget what you said about me.
Yeah, the beauty of hypocrisy.
Hypocrisy, absolutely. So I'm not against anybody. I don't agree with a lot of people's opinions, and I express myself. I don't lie. And people said I was lying about the Jester. Well, that's called trolling people, okay? But when I say something and say, I'm not lying. That's just the way it goes. I don't believe in lying because lies come back and bite you in the ass. That wasn't a lie that would come back and bite me in the ass, you know what I mean? It was a troll. It was meant to do what it did. I achieved my accomplishment, and 2 years later, it's still going on, and I thought it time to squash it. So that's what I did.
Yeah. Then again, Jester is kind of obsessed with everyone that pokes him. He goes after, like, even the smallest trolls, too, which I've always found fascinating, including this 16-year-old kid. He tried doxing and posting YouTube videos of him talking about his Xbox because he called Jester a fail.
Huh. Well, that's too bad that people have to be like that. And it's too bad that this, we're living in America. I don't know if you are, but apparently Jester is. And on freedom of speech and not go along with freedom of speech. So if you're living in Timbuktu and they believe in, you know, fry your bread on one side and don't fry it on the other side, and he's frying it on both sides, you're kind of going against the principle. And then you're standing up for the principle of the United States, that freedom of speech and do this and that, and then go against it.
Yeah, it's ironic since he's all patriotic, too.
Well, I don't want to put the guy down. I mean, he's got his place on the internet. We all do. And more power to him. Like I said, he does help out in some doxing and does help out in some ops, very few. You're not going to see him with a Guy Fawkes mask on. But you're not going to see any real Anons with the Jester outfit on either. But then again, he made a name for himself on the internet. He shows up here and there. He shows up over here. He's on this place. They got rooms full of DEF CON where they're interviewing him. You know what I mean? So that's what he's on the internet for. He achieved what he's doing. More power to him. If that's what he wants to do, do it. But as for me, I don't have nothing to do or post anything on him since that Smidley or whatever?
Smidley Butter, I think.
Yeah, Smidley. But that was the last time I said anything because I was dragged into it. People start saying, hey, are you know, blah, 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 and this and that, da, da, da. It's like, no. I have nothing to do with that. I have a feeling I know who it was because they used the old phrase at the end of it. Rick Veda loves you, and so do I. And that's something that I say at the end of all my shows and in posts and things like that. And, you know, so whoever did it knew how to put little crumb trails out there to lead to me. And he fell for it and came after me. And I was honest, told people I had nothing to do with it. I don't know who did it. I'm not him. So.
And he didn't get any bitcoins out of it either, which is another funny thing that no one even, like, I think it was like a hundredth of a cent or something that the Smedley guy got for trying to get people to buy stocks.
Well, I don't know about bitcoins. I know about them, but it's something I don't want to be obsessed over because I got an addictive personality, and anything I do it to the extreme. And I have enough addictions to where I don't have to be addicted to bitcoins and watch them pile up. So I don't need no bitcoins. But everybody, you know, people like that Farmville, and people like games like that, and them are addictive, and that's why I stay away from that kind of shit, and because I get addicted to it. So. But, yeah, more power to people out there getting their bitcoins and things like that. It's something to keep. It's a hobby. And that's good, you know, that people have hobbies and they get out and do stuff. And that's fine, you know. And I'm actually looking for a game that I can get addicted to. But I want to pick out a good one.
Yeah, rather than watering virtual plants.
That I cannot do. My wife does it. My father-in-law does it, and they go back and forth about their planting and stuff. And sometimes if it's summer, I get tricked up into thinking it's a real garden. And it's like, oh, you got watermelons? And they grow that fast? And it's like, oh, shit, you're talking about that stupid game. Okay, never mind. But, yeah, that's more power to people.
I find it just creepy. Like, why not get a real garden instead of, like, logging on to Facebook and playing with some fake garden?
Well, it's like the bitcoins. I mean, bitcoins are supposed to be worth money and things like that, but it's addicting. It's like on the poker sites when they were around, I guess they're coming back in a year or two when they make it legal, but they used to be all over the place, and now it's really hard to play poker on the internet. But anyways, they have play chips. So I not only played real money, but I got addicted to the play chips. I wanted to build up my play chips because people were saying that they had $1 million in play chips. You start out with $2,000, I think, or something like that in play chips. So I was like, God damn, I want to try that too. And I got addicted to play chips. I mean, instead of going over making money, sometimes I would go in there and try to build up my play chips, which are worth nothing on full tilt. On a absolute poker, you get $50 for every $10 million you get, and then a invite into a free roll, which is, if you win it, you get $800. But full tilt was zip. You got nothing. Absolute poker, you got money. But anyways, long story short, too late, but it was addicting. I got addicted to the play chips.
Gotta keep them all or stuff like that. Just keep collecting and collecting.
So now they closed the site down. Full tilt is gone. Absolute is gone, or it's not in America no more. They took a few bucks real money off of me. They took all my play chips away. But they're coming back. They're supposed to have your name still there. They tell you your money's still on there. And when they do make it legal here in America, Full Tilt will give you your money back. And all the other well-known poker sites like Poker Stars, Ultimate Bet, Absolute Poker, and Full Tilt will all give you your money back. So all the poker players out there, don't worry about it. You're getting your money back in about a year or so.
Long time to wait.
Well, it's better than nothing. And on top of that, it'll be legal. So that means Uncle Sam's going to want a chunk out of your money when you win money. So you want to win a big tournament, which they have some big, big tournaments. Uncle Sam's going to want a chunk of it. That's the only bad thing about it. But, hey, Uncle Sam gets his too, I guess. Everybody gets a cut. But back to the Jester. Hey, Jester, I tell you what, buddy. I know you're listening, and that's fine. You don't have to call in. Here's what I can tell you is that I have no beef with you, brah. And that video, that's yours. You can do what you want with it. Make copies of it. If you want a new one where you can see my face, I'll give you a new one. Again, I don't censor people. I don't block people. You want to show you're a man? Unblock me. My profile, John Tiessen. And that'll show something, that you don't censorship me. It's a start, bro. It's a start. But what do you think about the Idle No More movement there?
The Idle Worm? What?
Idle No More, with the indigenous people around the world getting together, protesting the taking of land in Canada.
Oh, I haven't heard of that yet.
Oh. Well, it's out there. We got the indigenous people, the Native Americans in America, also the people in Canada. They are starting the uprise. We got a actual revolution starting in America. And Big Brother don't think it's... They think that these are a anonymous movement, the anti-SAC, the whatever movement. They don't understand who they're messing with. And they're messing with my brothers and the indigenous people, the Anishinaabe, the Native Americans, the First Nation people in Canada. And they don't know what they're doing. They done woke up a beehive, and it's growing, and it's getting bigger, it's worldwide. And everybody's picking up on it. The anonymous movement's in on it now. All the freedom groups are in on it now. It's starting to hit the media because they can't ignore it no more. And this is going to be something so big that everybody is going to feel it one day and see it in their front yards, in their backyards, in their shopping malls. Right now they're having flash mobs throughout the country. Mall of America, the biggest mall in America, we have a big flash mob out there. They arrested Belcourt at the IDS Tower in Minneapolis. That's a elder for the American Indian Movement, AIM. They arrested him. That pissed off the AIM movement. So now they rattled their cage. It's big. It's big. This is going to be so big. And they're not reneging. They're not going back on what they did. And as they took some land away from the First Nation people in Canada, and they're going to go ahead and go along with it. And what the First Nation people are doing is they're going to stop it. And they will stop it. There will be blood spilt over this if they do not turn around and change their ways. So I want everybody to know that. Hey, caller, I can't thank you enough, buddy, for calling in.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I think I'm going to end the show. And again, nothing wrong with the Jester people. He's just another person on the internet that does his thing. And I have no beef with him. I have no fight with him. I appreciate everybody. I love my enemies and I love my friends. And Rick Veda loves you. So do I.
Book of Revelation, chapter 7, verses 16 and 17.
Yes, sir.
They shall hunger no more, neither shall they thirst anymore.
Preach, preach up.
For God shall wipe away,
yes, sir,
every tear from their eyes.
Yes, sir.
Get ready for the revolution.
What
you say?
Break me, 'cause I'm down with Christ. Don't try the new nation, and we still alright.
Well, alright.